Welcome back again. This is Fox, the next instalment in our Satisfactory playthrough. Now, when we finished the last one, we were working on this turbo fuel setup, producing enough turbo fuel for 10 generators. Now, I think I ballsed up because we need 900 turbo fuel because we're going to overclock. We're going to overclock the gens. It's 200%. That means we are going to need more. It's going to be 45 sulfur. Times 10, it's 450. Yeah, we knew that. Petroleum coke. So is the oil. We are going to need to up the oil. We do need 600 oil. So at some point, I'm going to need to bring another oil pipe down here. This is 300 in this one, if I remember right. Yeah, this is overclocked to 300. There was another one around here, wasn't there? Yeah. Yeah, so we've easily got enough oil here anyway, so for now, we will simply bring another oil pipe along here. Each one of these pipes is going to have to deal with five of these setups making the turbo fuel, and in turn, each setup will power 10 overclocked fuel gens. I've also been thinking about how we can actually set out the production on top of this pier. We'll talk through that in a moment. Just going to go back and colour these in so we don't have to do it later. So yeah, I like the fact that these are offset compared to the foundation at the bottom, but this central column, it's a pain. Like, you see what I'm having to just snake the stuff around it? It's not looking very good. So I think I'm going to delete this central column. And the oil pipe going up. Turn this back to, so it's in line with the foundations at the bottom, where the pipes and everything are coming along. I think it will enable us to make everything look a lot neater. And will essentially speed everything up drastically. What we are then going to do is, instead of trying, I was going to do a sandwich layer, do all the belting and stuff underneath, but instead of trying to fit it all on one platform, we're going to have one floor making the turbo, one floor making all of the goods that need to go into the final blender for the turbo fuel, and then put the turbo fuel blender on top on one of its own. This is going to waste a little bit of time now, but everything's going to be so much cleaner and more organised at the end of it all, so. Definitely worth it. Delete you. This is getting no power now because it all came from the top. We can bring that back down again. Right, so water's going to be running up this face. Oil will bring up this face. Oil will bring up this face, sorry. So the pumps are going to be running. Pumps want to be running down. Water, oil. So the pumps are going to be running down these two sides, so we need to get this. Straight up this one. Delete the water extractor, we'll get it a bit more central. Water, oil. Right, let's use the top pipe for the oil. can we get Mark 5 lift straight on there? No, we do need a little bit of... just not enough. This wants to go up to the next floor, actually. Maybe even higher than that, but for now, we'll just give it its maximum. Can you rotate these conveyor holes? It's right on the edge in the centre. Side. Okay, that's good. Now we just need to set the pumps up. Now what's the power consumption on these pumps? 8 megawatt. 4 and 8. This does more than half again, so it makes more sense to use the Mark IIs. So they should be enough. Right, that is going to make everything so much easier from now on, getting them up this central column. I know it's twisted when we get to the top, but I'm not bothered about that. So, as I said, we're going to process everything down here that the blenders need on the next floor up. So, Let's see how high a refinery is. That's going to be the tallest building we need. And we'll build up some walls. I mean, the stack's buried a little bit in there, but I'm not too fussed about that. So we've got this to play with. So I probably will need these here when it comes to bringing the petroleum coke and stuff up. So let's put the blender. The main blender. Okay, turbo alternate turbo blend fuel, and we want to overclock this, so we're making 90 a minute. So 90 a minute needs 2x what we've got listed here, so 30 fuel, 60 heavy oil residue, 45 sulfur, which we've already got sorted, and 50 pet coke. So that 60 heavy oil residue needs to be added to the amount of heavy oil residue it takes to make the petroleum coke. This needs 40 to make 120. We need 50. So if we said 17 heavy oil residue and 60, so if we said 80 heavy oil residue, what about the fuel? That's in a blender. It needs 50 to make 100, and we need 30. Which means we need 15 for that. So if we said 95, say 100 heavy oil residue a minute, just to be sure. I'll bring up the calculator quick. That right then, am I? Let's do these sums again quick. So the top blender needs 30 heavy oil residue a minute, it's going to be 60. So that should be 600 on its own. Turbo. Blend fuel. That's without any of the stuff needed to make anything else. Six, seven, eight. 900 heavy oil residue. Yeah, so I was probably about right with 90, weren't I? I said 100. It's going to be 90. If it's 900 to make 900 turbo fuel, each one of these stacks is going to be making 90. That means we need 100 heavy oil residue. 90, sorry. A 90 heavy oil residue from the oil. That's what we want to do first. So here is the oil. This makes 40. Can we overclock this to make 90? Yes, we can. And all this needs is the crude oil. No crude oil getting to it yet. What's happening? Because I got it the wrong way around, of course. This is then going to need a sink to deal with the polymer resin. Well, so two-thirds of this needs to go up to the top, and a third needs to make the petroleum coke and the fuel. So... this one can do petroleum coke. Petroleum coke. How much did we need of that? 45 a minute. Five petroleum coke a minute. This uses 15, and we should need 15 blender. Should use the rest. To make the diluted fuel, heavy oil residue and water. Fuel, we need 30 a minute. This needs power. I will move these power cables around. I don't really want those showing out there. We'll deal with that later. Just want to make sure it's all working. Let's try and get it more central to this foundation. There's no water in there. No water in there. Nothing in there. Nothing in there. Nothing in there. No power. Might explain. This is making a petroleum coke. Turn that blend around. Bring everything up here. So two of them. Two of them. Petroleum coke. Still too close. Sulfur. Sulfur, petroleum coke. This is making the fuel. And the heavy oil residue needs to come direct from this here. We'll need a pump. This is a little bit noodly, but it's going to work. No power. Why? What's happened? What's happened? So the fuel, we only wanted to make 30 fuel a minute, if that's correct. That should need 15 heavy oil residue. Color code everything so it's easier to trace what's going on. Just needs power now. Again, I'm gonna, when I leave this video today, I'll clean all this up, hide all the power cables. Just want to get everything running, make sure it can do what it's supposed to do. Fuel is there. Fuel residue. Maybe I need to change these to mark two pumps. Yeah, it must be the same. Mark 1 pump. Unless we can... How much head lift does the actual blender have itself? Doesn't say. I know it has some, but... Just put a Mark 2 pump on just to be sure. Now we should be cooking in a minute. No. Still not working. There we go. Alright, why are you stalling? Let's crank this up to get a bit of a buffer in there. Turn the heavy oil residue. Yeah, heavy oil residue is already full. So it shouldn't be a problem. Turbo fuel is full now. Turn this back down to 30. Now we're good. So all we need to do now I need a 10-sided shape or two banks of 5. I don't know what's going to look best. If we just do it 9 and then clock them so that they use 10 each instead of 9 each. Is that possible? Let's just build one production. Power. We need a central column to bring all this up. Which was the middle one? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Or even if we do 12. Seven and a half a minute each, that'll probably look a lot better. It's like four a side, isn't it? It's 120 times 291.5. 4,000, that doesn't sound right. 7.4 times 120. 900 turbo for it. Yeah, so that's what we'll do. We need four banks of four around the central spine. That means this is going to have to be a lot bigger. So, can we fit four each way on this little platform? Center line is that line. Still got to be bigger. These things are going to take up a lot more room than I thought. It's going to look cool when it's done. Center line. And it needs to be three aside, doesn't it? You're a fucking twat. So we probably can shrink it down quite a bit. Let's try here. I think this is going to be the one. So it's two from the back, then half through the next one. might be able to do something with these corners and change the shape of it, make it look a little bit better on completion. Now we really want the pipe coming up dead centre, and that would look a lot better. I want that to be on top like that, but this is not possible, is it? This is not a five-way junction. If that's the case, might as well stick to how it was. Didn't put that one quite centre. Yeah, I think that's better. It's going to be one continuous loop then. Should help even everything out. I've got to underclock all of these and to whatever it was that they needed. Spawning some more power shards. Thank you. And I'll let this pipe fill up now before I connect the other two middle ones as that one and that one. But yeah, these things are massive, man. I need 10 of these. Maybe I can do it, so... do it so the corners touch. I don't know how easy that is going to be when we have to start snaking around the water, but time will tell. Are big. That's what I wanted. Big. It's going to look good from a distance. It's going to look massive. So, is the pipe full? No, not quite. Slowly building up. These are all full, which is good. The ones that are working. It means the pipe will slowly fill up. Over time. Let's check the production down beneath, below. Everything should be full. Yep. Petroleum coke. Yep. Fuel. Yep. Sulfur, we're good for anyway. Slowly filling up. Let's think about what we can do on the design of this while we wait. We need a red swatch for the turbo fuel. I think I like them better when they're white, just with the red pipes. Yeah. We needed to float this. wonder if it's possible to channel that all the way down to there. Now, would it be the other ramps to fill those in? Can you not set walls at an angle? There must be a way of using something to clip walls off. Thought I saw somebody using these. Obviously not. What about walkways? I know you used to be able to connect stuff from walkways. Maybe not. Maybe somebody can give me some insight of how I could get a wall going straight up from them. So that would look pretty cool. Do you have foundations? No, but we do then. They look pretty cool. they look good. I think they look really good. Brutal. I could really do with encasing this in though. I don't want to see this, so let's try. Standard fix it wall. Yeah. Quickly finish this bit and then we'll wrap this video up. These look really good. Look very, I keep saying the word brutal, but they do. It's like rough edges, big shapes, but because it's such a big structure, I don't think it looks very odd. I think it looks really good. Everything's working as intended. Everything's looking good. I'm going to call it there. That's an hour and 30. This is generally what it's going to look like. I will box this in, maybe do some detailing. Close this in round here. Do a little box at the bottom to hide the water extractor. I'll do that not recorded. And then at the start of the next video, I'll show you that. And then, yeah, it's just a matter of repeating this 10 times. Must be mad. Looks good though. As always, please give it a thumbs up if you enjoyed this. Subscribe, join the Discord, and yeah, we'll see you in the next one.